My name is Peter Huis. I am a member of the International School of the Golden Rosy Cross. And together with my friend Dorie de Zelle, we've prepared a little video, more or less a chat, on some of the aspects of the age of Aquarius, the upcoming age in the sequence of zodiacal signs that the Earth passes through. And we look upon it foremostly from a point of view of the liberation of the higher soul in man. You see, in the previous age, the era of Pisces, one of the foci lay on religious institutions. Institutions that would tell us how to live, how to act, how to serve the churches for the powers that be. Churches and state, they went together, they had a very powerful position in almost every country in Europe, in the previous era. The upcoming age, the age of Aquarius, will show a completely different focus. There, the focus will lay on the individual human being. So all those qualities that were talked about in the previous era, they are coming, they are becoming, they are developing inwardly in every person. For example, there will be the upcoming equality between men and women, and even a more important position for female. There will also be attention for equality, for liberty, and for freedom, and for brotherhood, those high aspects that were introduced during the French Revolution but never really got hold in society. And and we will have attention for the period in between those two signs, in between those two eras, the era of the Pisces, which is going out now, and the upcoming era of Aquarius. Because in between those two times, there will be a kind of a vacuum, a kind of a openness in which very high, unequivocally, spiritual powers flow into our earthly atmosphere, and every human being can do his advantage thereof. New possibilities arise, and everyone can step to a higher level of consciousness, even to a higher dimension, if I may say so.
The Aquarius person is a real etheric person, so that
etherical, living, having his conscious form mostly in his etheric body. Or, but we would more say in his living soul, and this living soul lives on when the body ends, dies.
And but all we see around us is more and more etherical, and so for me that's a kind of confirmation that more and more things are turning in the etheric part of the world. Yeah. It's like the internet, for example. It's maybe a strange example, it's like that, but
what you see is Aquarius is also the era of unraveling of things. It will be very difficult throughout the age that's coming to keep things hidden. So everything
kind
will
of
come
unmasking, or
unmasking. Yes.
Yeah. So you can more and more see also thoughts and feelings of other people, because it's
that might take a bit longer than the Aquarian age era only. In the esoteric knowledge, it's always said that those kinds of characteristics will be developed in a much further
But it's, I think in the book of Meerdat, that Meerdat says that you have to live like everyone can read, can read your thoughts and feelings. Yeah. So that it's open to everyone, and that you don't have to be ashamed of what you are thinking or feeling. Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful. The thing about Aquarius is that we are now going to live to our potential. Our inward potential. There comes a time that the severity of the Pisces era will mellow, and the characteristics of Aquarius, which are fraternity, equality, and freedom, that those are what started with as a precursor in the French Revolution. Yeah. Those are the characteristics for an Aquarian people.
Hmm.
And there's another very striking thing, I think, that is that in the time when those two periods change, which is what we are now living, then there is a kind of friction, and in that friction falls the prime orderly life of the creation, has a much more easy access to the dense atmosphere that we are living in. And that is an extraordinary thing, which makes that for people who live now, there's a possibility that they can see more clearly now, that they can see what everything, if you are a seeker at least, what it is all about, and what are the real important things that I want to achieve in my life. Because we are all conscious, or we are all consciousness, and we have to, and we can develop our potential in that sense. Consciousness can become much and much more clear.
It's funny because we developed like real individuals in the last centuries, that becoming more and more an individual, and on the other hand, that is necessary to develop a kind of real responsibility. Yes, to take your own responsibility, not led by other people to develop that consciousness, but led by yourself.
That's called also maturity. You have to be a mature, a grown-up person who is able to love and who is able to take responsibility, not only for his own actions, that in the first place, of course, but for the whole, for his whole surrounding, for his whole environment where he's living. And you see that, you see all those inventions that are being done, all those things that are being developed now to better the our planet, to take care of our climate.
I thought of this symbol because it's a kind of symbol what you showed us also in the book, the Aquarius symbol they used for the conferences in the 60s of the last
previous century.
But I think there was image with that three suns and also that cross.
Mm-hmm.
But here you also have the sun as aurora for my feeling. So what is this symbol saying for us?
This is a symbol of Aquarius. You see here, actually this is the symbol of Uranus, the planet Uranus, and that is the lord of Aquarius. That is the planet that is the most important in the Aquarian era. And this planet, Uranus, is the higher octave of Venus, and Venus is the earthly love, the love that we all know, that all people know, and that the animals know as well. But Uranus is the altruistic love, the love for all, for the whole creation, for everything that is, and a kind of love that makes you one with me and everybody united, and in a way that that you care for each other.
Hmm. And why is water so important? Hey, you see the waves of water. Is water a serious element of the Aquarius era?
This water symbol is associated with the water bearer, Aquarius. The Aquarian man is the water bearer. Although it is an air sign, yeah? It's not a water sign, it is an air sign. And the previous era that is now more or less finishing was the Pisces area, and that was a water sign.
Funny that it's then an air sign, and it's so for me associated with water also this sign.
Yes, but that's not strange, because it was always said in the esoteric knowledge that the water bearer poured out his jar of living water over humanity, or over the earth, or over our planet. And they took this symbol, they changed it obviously, because you see here the sun, you see the earth in there, and you see the sword, you know, which is the sword of Christ, the two-edged sword of Christ. And so it's not quite the symbol of Uranus. Not only it's elaborated, and the nice thing about Aquarius and the new period that's now coming is that the previous period that was about religion, and we have seen all those religious wars throughout the centuries, and people had to live in the same way as God said that you should live, and the priest said how God wanted us to live, you know. And it was about the suppression of the woman throughout, it was the patriarchal time. And now we see a shift towards a new era that's coming, the dawn of Aquarius, as was sung about in the 60s. And that is the age of man, of the human being, human being, man and wife. So what we thought that was put upon us as a burden, you have to live like that, otherwise you will not be in the kingdom of heaven, is now all people will develop to have that, all those qualities inside themselves. They won't look to institutions outside of them. You are a true living human being because you are godlike.
Is a school like the School of the Rosy Cross then still important as an instrument to have this in this period? Is it becoming more and more important that we become our own temples, or how do you?
I think both things are true, in my opinion. I mean, you will see that many more people are going to develop the qualities that a true pupil also would like to live and would like to have, and does his best for to develop that. But on the other hand, to be in a school like the initiation school of the Golden Rosy Cross, that is even something different. There's another aspect to that, because everyone can develop his own potential. That is a new era promising. But being together in a group with the conscious offering of your time and of your focus and concentration on a common goal, to be together, those are extra things in which we can do a lot for the atmosphere, the vibration of the planet also, and which can help people if we truly are together and can put aside all our differences and focus on a one spiritual goal, that has a tremendous effect in throughout the
it's maybe a kind of lesson also for us to practice unity, yeah? Because if you are also, in a group, then you have to practice that unity, and if you are alone, then you you it's just have to care for yourself,
yeah,
eh?
So
if you being in a group is practicing,
It's practicing unity, and this unification is one of the aspects of Aquarius also again. So there are great times coming up.
Maybe the temple, the temples of the Rosicrucians are, and that's also the coming together in a temple, that is like giving a synergy between people, if you if you add one and one, it's not two but it becomes three, and if you are with people,
well, you won't pass your exam if you say that, do you?
With people on the same concentration, then it's you feel that it's becoming more than if you are alone in house. And we can that feel nowadays with this COVID period, that we are not coming very often together, and then I'm wondering if it's just me that is missing the fact that I'm not being in the temple. But it's more than that. It's that special place where you feel our different ethers spread, and then if you are just only in your house, so it really is a working place for pupils.
Yeah, for pupils. Yeah.
But we can experience this now so directly because of the fact that we are not going there every week or whatever.
It's really good that you say that, because just the other day I was thinking about we have homes, and we have homes and we need homes because we always say our bodies are too weak to be just outside there, but that is not quite true. We need homes because we are spiritual beings. And those homes, although they are also very important for our biological existence, these are the places where we can think freely, where we can develop our own thoughts. And if you take that further, you see that is why we built those temples in the past, to have places where you can be together as spiritual beings and focus on specific spiritual items or subjects that you want to talk about. And while building the temples and being in the temples, we build this, what is called in the manifestos of the Rosicrucians, the Domus Sancti Spiritus, or the House of the Holy Spirit, as it is called. And that is a vibration field. That is a vibration field where this new etheric body or our new spiritual soul belongs to and is at home there. And that is even, and that's just what you said, you when we have these online conferences, it is absolutely certain that we are embodied by this Domus Sancti Spiritus, the House of the Holy Spirit. That is the thing that binds us together, and that gives this strong experience of I was in the temple, although I'm at home on my bench.
And that's funny, that's also maybe a sign of Aquarius, because you don't see each other, but you feel connected.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
It's the soul that is connected with all pupils around the world, especially in the English environment. We are united with people from America and Australia. And we feel connected.
Yeah, you feel connected. Yeah.
And that's funny.
Yeah, great. Well, thank you very much. It was good.